Wouldn't it be great if you could do one action within Trello and then a multiple number of actions could be applied? For example, what if I could take this task right here and drag it over into this new list and then have it automatically apply a due date, a checklist, and myself, just like it did right there? Well, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to do exactly that. I want to show you everything you need to know about Butler automation. Now, earlier this year, Trello gave Butler to absolutely everyone, including free users or those just using the basic version of Trello. The great thing about this is that it actually doesn't count as to one of your power-ups, so you can use Butler in conjunction with a number of other power-ups, including custom fields. So let's jump right in and get comfortable with the Butler interface. In order to do so, you just need to select the Butler button, which appears in the top right-hand corner of all of your Trello boards. Now, the very first screen that you're going to see is called Automation Tips, and Butler is going to try and give a few suggestions based on your behavior as to the types of things that you might want to include. But I'm going to go directly to rules, because rules is going to be the most important area and probably the area that you most frequent when creating automated actions here within Trello. Now, a little later on, I'm going to show you the differences between the five different automation categories here within Butler, but rules is at the top for a reason, because rules are going to be things that are applied based on other actions. So here you see a rule that I just performed. It says, when a card is added to the list in progress by anyone, set the due date to 48 hours, add the follow-up checklist to the card, and join the card. And you saw that happen in real time. But let me walk you through creating a new rule from scratch. I want you to be comfortable with this interface and not be intimidated by all of the many options that are available to you. So first things first, we need to start with a trigger. This is going to be the cue that other actions or other things should be applied. So we're going to select Add Trigger, and here we are given a number of different options. Now, they're categorized in a few different groups. Movement, as in card movement or adding a card to a board or list. Card changes, this would include things like adding or removing labels, attachments, members, etc. Date-based, whether that's a due date or entering in information on a card that already has a due date. Maybe if a checklist is added or if a checklist is completed. Card content would include things like adding a comment within a particular card. And fields is all about custom fields. Remember, I mentioned you can use this with your own custom fields, which makes it that much more powerful. But in this case, let's start with card movement. And just to give you a bit of an idea of how this interface works, you can see they have tried to list it in such a way that you can just sort of read it out. So when a card is added to the board by me, that could be the trigger, and then we would hit the green plus button over here. But we have so many more options than that. If you hover over almost any one of these fields, you can see I can change added to created in, emailed into, moved out of, and instead of me, it could be by anyone or by anyone except me. In some cases, you may need to even click on some of these fields just to show you the other options available to you, but I don't want you to be intimidated by this. There's a lot of options, but that gives you that much more power as to what you want it to do. So let's create a simple one here together. Let's recreate something similar to what I showed you at the beginning. So when a card is added to, and added does mean created, copied, emailed, or moved into. If you want to be more specific, I can choose one of those other options, but I'm going to leave it as added. So I'm going to say when a card is added to a particular list, in this case, I'm going to choose ideas, and I really don't care if it's added by me. Actually, you know what? I'm going to stick this one with me because I want to make sure that I get added to this card. So I'm going to say added by me. Now, I have to go over to the right and hit the green plus button. That's actually going to add the trigger. If I scroll up to the top, you can see the trigger. There is the trigger that we just created. Now, step two is to perform an action. Now, one or more, and the great thing about Butler is that you can layer action upon action upon action. So let's add three actions in this case. First things first, I want to add a due date. So I'm going to select the dates option here. And you sometimes may have to read through a number of the options to find exactly what you are looking for. But I'm going to choose the second one. I want to set the due date. I don't want it to set to now, so I'm going to click on this. And wow, I've got a lot of options available to me here. But it looks like this second one is what I'm looking for. I want to set it to 48 hours. From right now. If I click on this clock, I could be really specific and actually say what time of day, but I'm going to click off that. I'm going to leave it at 48 hours from when that card is moved, and I'm going to select the plus button. Now, it should be noted, we actually have not added that action yet. We've just specified the time, set due date to 48 hours. I still need to come over here and hit the green plus button. If we scroll up, you can see that action has now been applied. But let's don't stop there. Remember, we can add as many actions as we like. Next up, I'm going to go to members because I want to join this card. I don't want to waste my time, you know, going into the card and adding myself and having to remember every time. So I'm going to choose this first one, join the card. I'm going to go over all the way over here to the right, hit the plus button, and now you can see that's another action which has been added. And maybe the last thing that I'm going to do in this particular case is I'm going to click on content. So I want to let my team know that, you know, I've got this or I'm going to look into this. So I'm going to scroll down to this option which says post comment, and I'm going to say I will look into this. All right. So that is the comment that's going to be added each time as a part of this rule. Again, I need to hit that plus green button, and you can see that that has been added as an action. Now, what's really important, don't forget to hit save at this point, because if I was to hit X, all of this is going to go away. Don't hit cancel unless you, you know, don't want this rule anymore, but make sure you remember to hit save. So after hitting save, you can see that we have this new rule and it tries to spell it out for us so we can come back and review it and edit it if we need to. But this is the rule that we've just created. Let's close this and see if it actually works. So here I am in the ideas list. That's where we set up the rule. I'm going to say add another card, and I'm going to say, create a new product. All right. So I'm going to hit enter on my keyboard, and what's going to happen? There we go. We've got the new due date. That's 48 hours from today. We've got the comment. We'll go look at that in a second. And it has attached myself to the card. I haven't done anything else. I haven't even clicked within the card yet. And it's automatically applied those three actions. If I open up the card and I scroll down, there's that comment we specified. I will look into this. So we've added three actions just by adding a card to this particular list. There are so many possibilities here within Butler. That was just a quick example to get you comfortable with the interface. Now, choosing the different options is going to be very similar for the other four ways in which you can apply Butler to your Trello boards. So let's just go through how you might use some of these different options. So here under card buttons, Butler gives you the opportunity to actually add a custom button within the card that can perform, well, almost any action or multiple actions that you want. So in this case, I've added a card button that's called Move Up, and it will move the card to the top of this list, the to-do list. So let's see if it works and where you will find it. So here's my to-do list. I'm going to click on the bottom card here, the one that is last in this list. And you will see under the power-ups menu, here is my custom Butler button. If I select Move Up, you're probably not going to notice much anything here because we're already within the card. But if I close it, you can see it automatically moved that card to the very top of the list. Great stuff. Now, one thing you should know is that when it comes to card buttons, you cannot specify them to a particular list. A card button, if I go anywhere, you're going to see this move up button. So if I was to click this right now, it's going to also move it. It's not just going to bring it up to the top of this list because we said move it to the top of the to-do list. So that's how card buttons work. Now, the board button is somewhat similar, but you will see that the board button applies to everything on the board. Here, right beside the Butler button is a board button which I have previously created. It's called Move Approved. And here's how this button works, or how I've created this particular button. Move each card with the green new project label in the list ideas to the list projects. So you might want to use a board button when it's something you want to initiate at a given time. I'll show you in a minute how you can initiate things based on a calendar date, but let's say over here, I'm going to add a label to just a couple of these. Let's add a label to the first and last one here. So maybe this is where the ideas start, and after a while, anything that gets this green new project label, I want to move it up over here. But what if I have a long list of these? I don't want to do it one at a time. That's why I've got my Move Approved button. So let me click that button here. You'll see down below, sometimes there will be a quick screen, Butler telling you what's happening. Oh, they're gone. Those cards have been moved from the ideas list, and here they are at the bottom of my projects list. Exactly what I wanted it to happen by using that board button. Let's go back into Butler and look at the last two options here. Now, it's hard to give them an example because they're both date related. The first one is a calendar command. And what this has to do with is when you want something to perform on a particular day of the week or day of the month, something that's going to happen on a regular basis. So in this example, I've created a calendar event that says every month on the 1st, archive all the cards in the list complete. And this is probably a pretty good example because for many of us, often we will have a complete or a finished or a done list, and this just accumulates a large number of cards. So maybe every once in a while you want Butler to automatically archive those cards. Well, and the 1st of the month, that's exactly what's going to happen here. Everything in this list is going to be archived. And of course, you choose the time frame. You create the buttons. You create how you want to customize that rule. Last but not least, we have due date. And this is different than calendar because it's basing everything on the due date of the card. So in this example rule, I've created something that says on the Sunday, before a card is due, add the red urgent label to the card. So that means every weekend before a card is due, it's going to add this red urgent label only to those cards that have a due date in that coming week. I'd love to hear from you next. What types of automation will you be creating, and how much time is this going to be saving you? Because ever since I've started using Butler, I have saved so much time working with others and working within my Trello boards. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you subscribe right here to the Simpletivity channel. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.